Hello everyone, I'm Jessica, and today is going to be my wrap-up for the month of February. Last month in January, I did my TBR takedown and did like all of my haul and my wrap-up and everything all in that one video. I feel like if I did that this month, it would be like a 30-minute video, so I'm breaking it apart, and there will be a TBR takedown stats video instead. Three videos instead of one this time. Let's get to it. I read a total of 9 books in the month of February. 4 of those were during the Contemporary-a-thon, and the other 5 were just sporadically through the month. I will talk about the ones that I did during the Contemporary-a-thon a little bit, but if you want to hear more of my thoughts about it, I will link the video for the Contemporary-a-thon wrap-up in the description box below, as well as in the cards. And I'll also link all of my Goodreads links down below in the description box as well for all of the books that I discuss, as always. First, I have The Third Twin by CJ Amalolu. I still am not sure how to pronounce that. I gave this a 4 out of 5 stars. This book is about twins, Lexi and Ava. Anytime something bad happened, they blamed it on this fictional third twin named Alicia. And they do the same for boys that they think are hot and they want to date but aren't really good enough to date them. So the guys get to date Alicia instead. Some of the boys that they start dating start coming up dead, and all of the evidence leads to either Lexi or Ava, all of the DNA evidence. And Lexi is the person that we're getting the perspective from of the story, and she knows that she's not killing anybody, so she has to accept that either Ava is killing these boys or that Alicia is real. I really liked the writing style of this. I loved the characters. They were very fun to read. I did not figure out who the murderer was until about a page before the main character figured out who it was. I had a lot of thoughts, and a lot of my thoughts were kind of right, but none of them were dead on for what was actually happening, so I definitely liked this one. Next, we have The Princess Diaries by Meg Cabot. I gave this a 4 out of 5 stars. I'm not gonna tell you what it's about because there's a movie about it and it's super popular and whatever. I really enjoyed the writing of this. I do like that it was actually in a diary style. I guess I didn't expect that, but I don't know why I didn't expect that because, you know, Princess Diaries. This is so different from the movie. And I just really enjoyed it. I love that, spoiler alert, Mia's dad's alive in the book. What? So, like, in the movie, you know, Mia's dad is dead, and her grandmother is, like, this sweet old lady. I mean, she's strict, but she's sweet. In this, she's just a very different character, and her father is alive, and he is just, like, the sweetest. Then we have The Vanishing Stare by Maureen Johnson. This is the follow-up to Truly Devious. I gave this a 4.75 out of 5 stars. It was amazing. I'm obviously not going to tell you what this book is about because it's the second in a series, but the series follows Stevie, who goes to this academy where students are taught to learn things in a different kind of way. They are all basically Einsteins in their own right of their own different type of study, and Stevie wants to be like Sherlock Holmes. She likes to discover clues. She likes to figure out mysteries. And at the Ellingham Academy, the original founder's wife and daughter were kidnapped and or murdered and have been missing for like 80 years. And so Stevie goes there knowing that she wants to solve this murder. And while she's there, one of her classmates is killed. And so there's like a new murder in the modern day and a murder in the past tense. In the first book, you do not figure out who the murderer is on either case. In this book, you find out who the murderer is, but not really why or anything about the person that was kidnapped, and they've never found a body. So there's still that mystery, plus the mystery of who's killing people in modern times. It's crazy. There was just so much going on in this book, especially at the end. Next is On the Come Up by Angie Thomas. I'm gonna put this down because I literally cannot stand to hold it. It's just... I gave this book a 4 out of 5 stars. It is a somewhat follow-up to 2017's The Hate U Give. It follows a different set of characters, but is set in the same city. The reason why I put the book down, if you didn't watch any of my other videos where I have discussed it, it is textured and it feels awful. Just horrible. Feels horrible. I can't handle it. Yeah, so I can't stand here and hold it while I talk about it. I wasn't sure how I would feel about this book because it's not really about a topic that I have a lot of care about. I did really end up enjoying the story overall, though. The thing that really I love about this book is that it is just a place for Angie's writing to shine. She is going to be an autobi author for me in the future. I just absolutely love her writing style, and I love how she's able to write her characters in a way that they're able to learn how to speak up for themselves when no one else will, and to learn who they are. I think it's very valuable to especially young teens who are trying to figure out their place in the world. I think this writing style is definitely going to help them. The next book we're going to talk about is The Wicked King by Holly Black. I gave this a 4.75 out of 5 stars. I have read a lot of really good books this year, guys. Like, a lot of 4.75 star books. More than I would expect in only 2 months. This is the sequel to The Cruel Prince, which basically follows Jude, who is a human who was kidnapped and taken into the world of the Fae with her twin sister and her elder sister when they were small children. Her elder sister is actually part Fae, while her and her twin are both completely human. In this world, everything is kind of dark and not fair to humans in any way, shape, or form. So Jude has had to live her life trying to figure out how to keep herself and her sister safe and how to find her own place in this world, because even though she doesn't belong there, it is her home and it is where she feels most comfortable, which is a weird statement, but it's just how it is. This book was everything I could have wanted from a sequel and more. I loved the shift of the plot between parts 1 and 2 of this book. Just the plot twist, the way that it shook up everything was just amazing. And that cliffhanger ending, my friend, it was glorious, and I am dying while waiting for the next book. Next is Blood Witch by Susan Dennard. This is the third book in the Witchland series. It is the fourth book that's been published. There is a 0.5. It is important to read the 0.5, which is called Sight Witch. Very important to read to fully enjoy this series. I gave this a 4.75 out of 5 stars. Again, like I said, I've read a lot of those this year. I honestly considered giving this book 5 out of 5 stars, just going straight for the 5 out of 5 stars. But I feel like I might just be overwhelmed in how much I absolutely loved the story, and I may have missed some things that were, like, not perfect. So I took it down 0.25% just to, like, be more fair and to not just be like, it's a 5-star book, it's perfect, because I'm sure it's not perfect, even though I absolutely loved it. So this series follows Safi and Iz, who are best friends, who are basically on the run from a bunch of political people who want to either capture Safi for her rare magic and use it for themselves, or kill her so that no one else can use her magic against them. This series has a lot of found family elements, a lot of fighting, sea battles, just all kinds of action scenes. There is so much going on constantly. If you like books that are multiple perspective and have a lot of different, like, traveling elements and fighting and war and that type of stuff, you will really enjoy this series. I highly recommend it to everyone because it's beautiful. I love Suze's writing style. It is just immersive and fun, and I love the way that she writes her characters. They are gripping and they bring you in, and it's just glorious. This book went everywhere I wanted it to go and then some. It was wonderful. I just absolutely love all of the plot and how everything is starting to weave together. So many surprises, so many plot twists. I do plan to read this again in the month of March and do a full review video, as I have done for both Truth Witch and Wind Witch. Next we have Dangerous Creatures by Cami Garcia and Margaret Soul. This is one of my TBR box picks. I gave this a 3.5 out of 5 stars. It is a follow-up series to the Caster Chronicles, more commonly known as the Beautiful Creatures series. I did at some point kind of decide that I wanted to read the series based solely off of the fact that Ridley is basically my favorite character. I love that she is unapologetic and evil, and she knows that that's who she is, and even when she does something good, it's usually not for a good reason. It's usually for a selfish reason, because that's who Ridley is, and I love that about her. I love a character that knows that they're bad and just accepts that about themselves and tries to figure out how to get everyone else in their life to accept them for that as well. This series follows Ridley and another character that I won't tell you, because if you haven't read the Beautiful Creatures series, then it would kind of ruin, like, the romance aspect of it. But anyway, so this series follows Ridley, and it's just basically is her journey after the Beautiful Creatures series. My thing is, I don't like the writing style, and that is why I rated the Beautiful Creatures series so low, is because
I like the story and I like the world building, but I really just do not enjoy the writing style. And that's just a personal preference. And so if you enjoyed the Beautiful Creatures series, I'm sure that you will enjoy this as well. Or at least this book, because now we're going to talk about Dangerous Deception. Because I enjoyed Dangerous Creatures, I then read Dangerous Deception, which was not on any of my TBR, but like I read the first book, so I obviously would want to read the second book because why not? And I gave this a 3 out of 5 stars. This was disappointing for me. One of the most glaringly obvious things to me, which is weird, is that both stories include flashbacks. There are multiple perspectives, so they follow different character perspectives, and then there's also flashbacks in them as well. In the first book, and I read these back to back, and that's probably the only reason why I caught this, but in the first book, the flashbacks are in third person, as is everything else. In this book, the flashbacks were first person, and it was super weird. Like, you went from them talking about themselves in third person to them having a flashback in first person. And it just really threw it completely out of whack for me. I just could not get around it. Like, every time a flashback started, I was like, why are we doing this? Like, why is this happening? Another thing about this that just makes me feel like this series is a complete money grab on the part of the authors is that this book in particular had a huge cliffhanger ending, in my opinion, had a cliffhanger ending. Like, it wrapped up, but yet the story was not finished being told. Like, there's obviously more that comes after this. And they have no plans to continue writing it. And I feel like there was such a high of Beautiful Creatures when the movie came out, and they were trying to write more to get more money. And so they wrote these two books and just kind of strung them together and then was like, eh, no, we're done. Please don't do that to me, because now I will probably never read anything from either one of these authors ever again. Because A, I don't like the writing style, and B, because I feel like I've been taken. And the final book that we're going to talk about is Slayer by Kirsten White. I gave this a 4.5 out of 5 stars. This book is set in the Buffyverse, which is the universe of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, if you're unaware. This book takes place after the Buffyverse comics. I don't feel like you need to be familiar with either the comics or the TV series to enjoy this book. I think everything that you need to know to enjoy this book is in here. If you have read the comics or you have watched the TV show, I feel like you'll just enjoy it more because you'll get all of like the little hidden things in it that make it fun. This book is about Nina and her twin sister Artemis, who basically are part of the Watchers Council, which is this council that is set up to keep an eye on slayers and other demonic presence in the world. When the Buffyverse started, there was only one slayer ever chosen, and at some point during the series that system was broken, and every person who would have been a slayer, who was a potential slayer, actually became a slayer. So they made it so that there were thousands of slayers instead of just one, in a way to kind of combat helping the demon problem that was taking over the earth. There's some backstory for you. So something happens to Nina, and she thinks that she is like turning into a demon, but turns out she's actually become a slayer. And she has been overlooked her entire life, and everyone has kind of pushed her down and kept her at this level where they ignore her and they just kind of let her do whatever she wants to do. She's studied medicine and like how to help people rather than how to hurt people. So when she's called as a slayer, she's not sure what she can bring to that or why she was called. So this book basically follows Nina trying to figure out how to be a good slayer and what that means for her. I really love that aspect of it. I really love how it connected with the slayer presence in a way that I don't feel like ever happened in the TV show. I don't think, or the movie, because there's a movie too. I forgot completely about that. But anyway, so the TV show never really says a lot of the things that like Buffy herself in this book talks about as far as like what it means to be a slayer. And I really enjoyed that aspect of it. I really enjoyed that. I definitely cried while reading this book. Yeah. There's nothing that sad, but I cried because I have a lot of feelings about Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and that's just how it is. I really loved the characters in this, especially Killian. Killian was probably my favorite character from this book. And Doug, I really liked Doug. Doug and Killian, they were awesome. I enjoyed the writing, I enjoyed the plot. The last 50 or so pages were an absolute wild ride. It was a roller coaster, it was crazy. It was just like, hey, this happened, but also this happened, but also this happened, but hey, by the way, all that stuff that just happened doesn't matter anymore because then this happened. was crazy and I loved it. So those are the books that I finished in February. There are a couple others that I started reading but haven't finished yet, but I'll talk about those in my TBR for March.
If you have read any of these books and you have any thoughts on them, let me know in the comments below. I would love to discuss them with you. That is all I have for today. I post reading, writing, and book related videos twice a week. So until then, I will see you guys next time. Bye.